Jodi. I'm sure they'll be happy.
Russell and Aaron Freeman representing Lee Valley.
So now we've got Jodi Russell and Aaron Freeman.
Yeah, this is their also their first year at seniors. We've got a lot of newbies this year. They've just been competing nationally so far this season as well. Taking the fin step a little bit slower than the other couples so far. A little bit quick on the timing there. The music right in front of the judges there, that should help with the presentation mark. Slight wobble from Jodi on the end and a touchdown on the second twizzle. The technical panel will review her twizzles for the level. Together. Looked like her leg brushed the ice then. That would be something the technical panel would definitely review, but a very interesting position on the lift. I think they'll be happy with that. There was a couple of costly mistakes in there on the twizzles, and they will definitely review the lift at the end. But overall, from their previous performance, it was much stronger so far this season. They're a new couple, they're new to seniors. It will take a lot of time just to kind of settle in, gain that experience. And they're a little bit younger as well, so it can be a little bit overwhelming sometimes.
What have they achieved so far in their season?
I'm not sure. I know they competed at the qualifying event in Dundee. I'm not sure so far. I think they have progressed this season with their scores, which is what any skater wants to see, you know, a progression. If they're going down every event, then you've got a problem. You want to see your scores going up. Or even, you know, with the levels, say for your twizzles, you get a level 2 at one event, you want to try and get a level 3 at the next event. You know, every skater has their own personal goals. It's not necessarily going to be a gold, a silver, or a bronze. It'll be getting a certain level on an element.
Yeah.
And then they'll be happy.
So they've been pretty happy with their progression.
I think so, yeah. And they seem quite happy sitting there, quite relaxed.
It was a really joyful programme. It was really nice to watch.
Yeah, they seem to enjoy it. Their interpretation was good. The costumes are great. I think they really fit the theme.
It's a very different costume to any that we've seen before.
Mm-hmm. Not so many sparkles.
Yes. Much less on the sparkles.
Yeah. It's in some ways, the costumes can sort of become an identity.
Mm.
There's some skaters who have really different costumes and you can't wait to see what they come out with every season just to see how different they're going to be.
So some of the skaters in the ice dance, they seem to start skating slightly later than some of the free skaters. So Aaron didn't start skating until he was 11.
Yeah, you do find that. It's with the figure skaters, with the jumps. Internationally, the kids are very young when they're doing the quads and the triples. And unless you've got that at a young age, you just won't be able to compete internationally on the world stage. It's, I mean, dance is as difficult. We don't do the jumps. It's as difficult in its own right, but it's, the jumps are a lot harder to learn.
It's not quite so early specialization as the free skating is. No.
You'll find it on the world stage as well. A lot of the dancers are a lot older than what the free skaters are. I mean, the last Olympic champion in ladies figure skating, she was 15 years old. That's the lowest threshold that you can go.
Jodi and Aaron, total segment score 33.44. Jodi and Aaron are currently in third place.
So 33.44 for Jodi and Aaron.
Next to skate.